Okay, good morning students. In the previous class of company law, we discussed about the winding up, the kinds of winding up of the company, right? So we discussed about the compulsory winding up and even the voluntary winding up, right? So only those are the two kinds of winding up. In those two kinds of winding up, we explained the various provisions and the rules in that whenever the company is going to wind up the company by voluntary mode or by the order of tribunal, that is nothing but compulsory winding up, right? So today in this class we are going to discuss about the removal of company's name from the register of companies. That means after winding up, the next procedure is only the company's name should be removed from the register, right? So the register has to remove the company's name from the register of companies, right? Whenever the name is removed, then we can say that the company is completely closed, right? So whatever this procedure, actually we can say that this removal of company's name from register of companies is nothing but the dissolution procedure. So separately there may be a chance of coming this question as in this way. The question formation may they ask in like explain the dissolution procedure of a company, but we have only the topic removal of company's name from register of companies. That is nothing but the dissolution procedure. So after winding up, whenever the order has been passed from the tribunal to the company to wind up the company, after the passing of order, how the dissolution procedure will be there, right? So after completion of all the winding up process, how the company will be dissoluted, here we need to discuss, right? So in this dissolution procedure, here we have the regulations, that means all the provisions are there. So whenever we are coming to this procedure, so provisions under the dissolution procedure, so what are the provisions? We'll first list out the provisions. First one, grounds for removal of name of the company. So grounds for removal of name. So what are the reasons why majorly the name of the company will be removed from the register? Grounds for the removal. So after all that, the notice to company, that means here the company's name is removing from the register of the company, we have to give that notice to company and to its directors, right? So to the company's directors and to the company, we need to send the notice. So after sending the notice, we need to publication of notice. Right. So after publication of notice, next we need to strike off the name, right? So that is striking off name by registrar. So here the registrar is an authority who will strike the name of the company from the register. So striking off name by the registrar. So next one, public notice. So after striking off, we have to give that notice. That means the registrar has been strike off the company's name from the register. So for that thing, we need to give the public notice. So after that public notice, we have to publication of that notice. So publication of notice of what? Publication of notice of striking of name by the registrar. So whenever the publication of notice is that, that is nothing but dissolution. So this is the last step, actually dissoluting the dissolution of a company. So whenever the dissolution has been completed, so there is no liability on the part of a director. So no effect on the liability of director. So whenever the directors are there, so after dissoluted of the company, so no liability has been raised on the director's part. So no effect on liability of director. Right. So these are the various points whichever comes under the dissolution procedure of a company, right? So first we list out the first one, grounds for removal of name of a company. So simply, why we will remove the name of a company from the register? Why the registrar will remove the company? So if the company failed to commence the business, whenever the business is going to start, so at the commencement only, if the company fails, right? So at the commencement stage only, if the company fails to conduct the activities or affairs of the company. So at that reason, or if the company fail you to pay the subscription to the subscribers or to the memorandum of the subscribers, if the companies fail to pay the subscriptions, that means the money, or if the companies fail you to carry on its business or its activities in the any of way, not only in the commencement stage, so in any way, if the company is going, if the company fails to carry on the various activities or various business transactions, right? So at that, these three reasons, right? So at these three reasons, the company is going to the registrar is going to remove the name of the company whenever at the commencement stage. So if the company has not operated well, or if the company has not paid any subscription amount to the subscribers, that means subscribers in the sense to the shareholders, if the company has not been any paid any amount, right? So, or if the company has failed all the transactions at any stage, not only at commencement stage, so if the company failed to conduct any transactions or any activities in the company, so majorly these are the major, not only these, so we have other reasons also. So if the company is unable to pay the debts, see, like these reasons also the company is going to wind up and then it will be dissoluted. But here majorly the registrar of the company will consider these are the main three grounds where if the company is going to dissolute it, the registrar will calculate these three grounds. So after calculation of these three grounds here, if the registrar wants to dissolute the company here, the notice will be there. By the registrar, it will send to the company and to the directors, right? So about the failures of a company, the registrar has within a reasonable time, it will send a notice to the company and to the directors of the company to remove the company's name from the register of companies, right? So whenever the notice has been sent, the notice has been issued, whenever the notice is issued by the registrar, as stated above, in the to the company directors and to the company, so in the prescribed manner, it will publish that the same notice, whichever is passed to the company and its directors, that will be published, right? So that means here it will be published in the official gazette of a company, right? So official gazette or official gazette of the company's register, they will publish that notice, whichever is sent to the company and directors, the same notice here, they will be published in the official gazette for the information to all the shareholders and to the all the creditors of a company. So whenever it is publicated, right? So after that, there is the registrar will strike off the name of a company. So the registrar they'll strike off the name whenever it is publicated in the official gazette. Whenever it is published in the official gazette, so the name of the companies will be striked off by the registrar from the register of company. So even though if any reasons are there, if the company mentioned any causes or if any reasons to the registrar, then there may chance to stop the striking off. But if particular reason or not mentioned by the company, so then even the notice, whenever the registrar has given the notice, before publish of that notice in the official gazette only, the company has to explain those reasons. If the company has not mentioned any reasons, or if the company has not mentioned any causes, right? So at that time, simply after publishing it in the official gazette, so the registrar will strike off the name of the company in the register, right? So after that, whenever the company's name has been striked off from the company's register, immediately they have to go for public notice. So on receipt of the application by the company, the registrar shall issue that publication in the official gazette. So one notice should be published before striking, and one notice should be published after striking of the name. So before that and after striking of name, so the notice should be the notice should be published in the official gazette of the company's registrar for the public information. So after all that, publication of notice in the sense, whenever the striking of the company's name from the official gazette, if it is published on the official gazette, so at that time it is the company should stand for dissolution, right? The company should should stand for its dissolution. So whenever it has been published in the official gazette, so immediately in the official advertisements, like advertisements or media, print or print media, so like the media, the register also should send the information to all the public while publishing it, publishing about the striking and dissolution of the company. So here in the public notice they will mention only the striking of name, so before that they will mention only the notice, but in this step they will mention that publication of notice, that means regarding to this notice again they will be published, and at the same time they will publish about the striking of the name of the company by the registrar, and they will also mention that is the process of dissolution of a company. That means whenever they mentioned in the publication that is dissolution of a company, so at that time the company is completely closed, right? So after closing of a company there is no at all regarding to the company, any task is not there. But even though if any effect is there, that means if any dues or if any liabilities are there in the company, that should not be reflected on the directors of a company. So whatever the liabilities or whatever the dues are there with the company, so that will not affected on the liability of the directors. So the directors having the, if they want to continue, they can continue with the same powers of the management. Even if every member of the company gets dissolved also, the liabilities of the dissolved person will not be affected to the director out to the manager. Okay. So this is the process about the dissolution procedure of a company. So still now we discussed all the winding up procedure and all the dissolution procedures of a company. So dissolution, winding up is completed. So in the next class we will discuss about the CL. That means company liquidator. So it's very important, guys, right? So please be learn about this winding up comparing to the dissolution procedure. Winding up is very important. So sometimes two wind ups comes under one question or separately. Okay. Thank you.